Good evening, all of you. This is Satish, Assistant Professor in St. Martin's Engineering College. Today, I am going to discuss about demand and what are the types of elasticity of demand that we are discussed today class. So, first we go for the first thing that is called as demand. So, what is demand here? See, in ordinary language, demand means it is desired to. In ordinary language, demand means desire. Whenever we are having a desire, simply we say that it is a demand of a particular commodity. But in economic point of view, the demand means it is not a desire. Whenever we are having of three things, at that time the demand will be existent to the particular product here. So what are the three things means? The first one is desire to acquire the product, and the next one is ability to buy it, and we are having of willingness to pay for it. Whenever these are the three things will be there in a particular commodity, at that time the demand will be existent to the particular commodity here. But whenever we have enough desire, it is not a demand of a particular commodity here. So simply, what is demand means? It must will be consisting of the three things. The first one is we have enough desire to acquire that particular product, and we have enough ability to purchase that particular product. And in what are the price will be there, at that price we are ready to pay for that particular price, then the demand will be existent with the particular product here. For example, if you are taking that, in a class we have enough 60 students. Whenever we have enough 60 students are there here. So here, in these 60 students, all the students they want, desire, have enough purchasing a laptop here. So all the people, they have enough desire to purchase a laptop here. But here, whenever they are having a demand, desire to purchase the laptop, it is not the demand of a particular commodity here. So in these 60 students, how many people they are having a desire and they are having a ability to purchase that particular product, and they are ready to pay for that particular price, at that time the demand is existent to the particular laptop here. So for example, the 60 people they are having a desire. So that means the first thing, all the people they have enough desire to acquire that particular product. But in the 60 people, only some people they have enough ability to purchase that particular product. What are the financial criteria or what are the interests, whatever it may be, they have enough ability to purchase the product here. For example, in the 60 people, only the 30 people they have enough ability to buy that particular product. And again, this 30 is also not to the demand of a particular product here. In this 30, how many people they are ready to pay for that particular price? For example, the laptop price will be having of 40,000. So in this 30, how many people are ready to pay for that particular price? Whenever they are ready to pay for that particular price, at that time the demand is existent here. For example, in the 30 students, only the 15 they have enough ability to, they have willingness to pay for that particular product here. So at that time the demand is existent to the particular laptop or particular commodity here. So that is called as demand here. So simply, the demand is here, thus the quantity of commodity purchased at a given price and at a given time and with the a given market, at that time the demand is existent to the particular commodity here. So that is called as demand of a commodity or demand of a particular product here. And when we go for the next one, what is elasticity of demand here? So here, what is the elasticity of demand means? Demand explains the relations between the changes in the price and the changes in the demand of a particular commodity here. So first the elasticity of concept will be given by the Marshall here. So what is the elasticity of demand means? What are the proportion of change in the price of a commodity? It leads to the proportion change in the demand of a commodity here. So how much the proportion they have to change here in the price and how much the demand will be changing here, that we have to discuss in the elasticity of demand. So simply, what is the formula for the elasticity of demand means? What are the percentage change in the quantity of demanded whenever we are changing the price of a commodity? For example, if the price of a commodity having of 10 rupees, it is increased to the 12 rupees. What about the demand will be changes here? what are the percentage of the demand will be changed here, so that we have discussed on the elasticity of demand. So simply, whatever the price, either it is changed as great or small, and how it is reflected to the demand of a commodity, that we have discussed on the elasticity of demand. And here, the elasticity of demand will be classified into two categories. The first one is elastic demand and inelastic demand. What is elastic demand means? Whenever a small change in the price, but it leads to the great change in the demand of a commodity here. So for example, a little change in the price, it leads to the more changes in the demand of a particular commodity here. So that is called as elastic demand. So simply, a small change in price, but it leads to a great change in the demand of a commodity. And if we go for the next one, inelastic demand. So it is quite opposite to the elastic demand here. So inelastic demand means whenever the price will be changed more changes are there in the price here, but it leads to the less change in the demand of a commodity, that is called as inelastic demand. So here simply the elastic demand will be classified into the two categories, elastic demand and inelastic demand. Elastic means a small change in the price, it leads to the more change in the demand of a commodity. If we go for inelastic demand, a big change in the price or more change in the price, it changes in the demand of a commodity, the less quantity, that is called as inelastic demand. And we go for the different types of the elasticity of demand here. See, when we go for the types of demand, elasticity of demand, we have enough majorly four types of the elasticity of demand will be there. The first one is price elasticity of demand, income elasticity of demand, cross elasticity of demand, and advertising elasticity of demand. So based on the price, we are discussing about the elasticity, that is called as price elasticity of demand. If you are considering the income, if you are considering the different product, if you are considering the advertising cost, how the changes will be there in the demand, that we have discussed one by one. So first we go for the first one, that is called as price elasticity of demand. What is price elasticity of demand? See, the Marshall is the first economist is discussing about the elasticity of demand or price elasticity of demand. So what is the price elasticity of demand means? If the price of a commodity will be increased or decreased, whatever the proportion change in the demand of a commodity, that is called as price elasticity of demand. See here, whenever we are changing the price of a commodity or some extent here, so how it is reflected to the, how much the changes are there in the demand of a commodity, that we have discussed on the price elasticity of demand. So we are using the formula of delta Q by the delta P into P by Q. So here the Q means quantity, P means price. Delta means the changes in the quantity and changes in the price into price by quantity. That is the formula for the price elasticity of demand. Here we are having of more types are there in the price elasticity of demand. Basically we are having of five types of the elasticity of demand. The first one is perfectly elastic, perfectly inelastic, perfectly relatively elastic, relatively inelastic, and unitary elastic demand or unit elasticity of demand. So we have discussed one by one deeply here. So first we consider the first one, perfectly elastic demand. What is perfectly elastic demand means? Here you see, whenever a small change in the price of a commodity or a product, that means a major change in the demand of a commodity here. So that means if the price will be changed slightly, either it is increase or decrease, a more change in the demand of a commodity, that is called as perfectly elastic demand. Always the perfectly elastic demand will be having of infinite. We are not expected that what are the number of quantity of the demand will be there, if the price will be going down or if the price will be increasing here. When you see the graph here in x-axis we are taking of price, in y-axis we are taking of quantity demand. If the price will be there in the P, the demand will be there. But if the price will be going down or if it is increased, then the demand either it is fell down to the zero, either it is increased to the infinity. So that is called as price elasticity of demand. Always the price elasticity of demand, a perfect elasticity of demand, it will be having a parallel to the x-axis. So always the perfect elasticity demand will be having a parallel to the x-axis, to the particular commodity. And we go for the next one. perfectly inelastic demand. Here, inelastic means whenever a small change in the, a big change in the price of a commodity, a big change in the price of a commodity, but there is a small change in the demand of a commodity, either they are having a no change in the demand of a commodity, that is called as inelastic here. So here, perfectly inelastic means if the price of a commodity will be changed, either it is increase or decrease, but there is a small change in the demand of a commodity, or maybe they are having a, there is no change in the demand of a commodity, that is called as perfectly inelastic demand. So whenever we consider the same thing here, price and quantity in x and y axis here, see, if the price be having of P1, the demand will be having of 2. If the price will be going down to the P2, the price will be having, the quantity will be having of 2 only. If the price will be fell down to the P3 also, then the quantity demand will be having of same here. So that means whenever the price will be increased or decreased, either it is increased, either it is decreased, but there is no change in the demand of a commodity, that is called as perfectly inelastic demand. Always the perfectly inelastic demand, it is equals to the zero. The best example for the perfectly inelastic demand is, if you are taking up the product of salt, whatever the money, whatever the price, either it is increased or decreased, but there is no change in the demand of this particular salt. If the price will be more means we are not eat more, if the less means we are not eat less. So the same quantity we are using, whenever the price will be changed, either it is decreased or increased here. So that is called as perfectly inelastic demand. And when we go for the next one, relatively elastic demand. See, relatively elastic demand means, see, whenever the price will be changed a little. So here the price will be changed from the P1 to the P2. That means the price will be decreased from the P1 to the P2. But the quantity is increased from the Q1 to the Q2. So here, whenever the price will be changed a little, but the demand will be changed more here. So that is called as relatively elastic demand. So whenever we are changing the price of a commodity, either the less increase or decrease, but a more change in the demand of a commodity, that is called as relatively elasticity of demand, or relatively elastic demand here. So whenever we are taking an example here, if the price of an apple having of 20 rupees, so the demand will be having of 400 units. But the price will be fell down to the 15 rupees, the demand is increased to the 600 here. Here, the price will be changed to 5 rupees, but the demand will be changed to 200 units here. So that means, if the price will be less changed here, but the demand will be increased more here. So whenever we are applying of these things, in, and when we go for the next one, relatively inelastic demand. See here, relatively inelastic demand means simply inelastic means a more change in the price, it reflects into the less change in the demand of a commodity, that is called as relatively inelastic demand. Okay. See here, if the price will be changed more, so here the price will be going down to the P2 to the P2 here, P1 to the P2 to here, but the quantity will be changed is little here. So that is called as relatively inelastic demand. A more change in the price, but the demand will be changed in less quantity, that is called as relatively inelastic demand. And when we go for the next one, unitary elasticity of demand or elastic demand here. See here, in this unitary elastic demand, whatever the changes are there in the price of a commodity, if the price will be changed some percentage, means the same percentage of the demand will be increased or decreased here. So how much the proper percentage of the changes are there in the price, the same level of the demand will be increased or decreased here. So that is called as unitary elastic demand, and always it is equals to the 1 here. So these are the 5 categories of, or 5 types of the price elasticity of demand will be there. And when we go for the next one, income elasticity of demand. So whenever we consider the income elasticity of demand, here we consider the income of the consumer. So if the income of the consumer will be increased or decreased, if the income of the consumer will be increased or decreased, so the demand, whatever the demand will be changed here, so that we have discussed on the income elasticity of demand here. So simply, whatever the proportion change in the income of the consumer, if the consumer will be, income will be increased or decreased, then whatever the changes are there in the demand of a commodity, that we have discussed on the income elasticity of demand here. And when we go for the next one, zero elasticity of demand. That means if the consumer income will be increased or decreased, it is increased or decreased, whatever it may be, there is no change of the demand of a commodity. That is called as zero elasticity of demand here. There is no change in the demand of a commodity. That is called as zero elasticity of demand. And when we go for the next one, negative income elasticity of demand. That means if the income will be increased by some amount here, but the demand will be decreased from the left to right side, leftwards here. That means if the income will be increased, but the demand will be decreased here. So that's why we say that it is a negative income elasticity of demand. The demand will be going wrong directions here. And when we go for the next one, unit income elasticity of demand. So whenever we go for the unit elasticity of demand means how much the income will be changed here. What are the percentages? If the 10% income will be increased means ultimately the 10% of the demand will be increased for the particular product here. So that is called as unit income elasticity of demand here. So what are the changes are there in the income? The same level of demand will be increased here. So that is called as unit income elasticity of demand. And when we go for the next one, income elasticity greater than unit here. So that means the income of the consumer will be increased a little, but the demand will be increased more here. So that is called as income elasticity greater than unit here. So it will be changed if the greater amount of the demand will be there if the income of the consumer will be increased here. So that is called as income elasticity greater than unit here. And when we go for the next one, income elasticity less than unit, it is opposite of that thing here. So simply, if the income will be increased more, but the demand will be increased less or decreased less here. So that is called as income elasticity less than unity. So these are the five categories are there in the income elasticity of demand. And when we go for the next one, cross elasticity of demand. What is cross elasticity of demand means? If you are taking up the two products, okay, if the one product price will be increased or decreased, here we are taking up X product and Y product here. If the Y price will be increased or decreased, ultimately it is reflected to the demand of another commodity here. So for example, if the Y price will be going down here, so at that time the demand of X will be going down. If the Y price will be increased, the demand of this X will be increased here. So that is called as cross elasticity of demand. And when we go for the cross elasticity, it is having of substitute goods and complementary goods here. The substitute goods means alternative goods. If you go for the tea and coffee, so these are the substitute goods. If the coffee is not available, we go for the tea. If the tea is not available, we go for the coffee. So at that time, if the price of the coffee going down here, so for example, the coffee price will be going down to the 10 rupees to the 5 rupees. Ultimately, who are taking the tea, they are converted to the coffee here. So at that time, the demand of a tea will be going down. Why? Because the price of the coffee will be going down here. So the demand of a tea will be going down here in the substitute goods. But if you go for the complement goods, here we are taking up the product. If we are taking up the complementary goods, it is purely vice versa of the substitute goods here. So whenever the price of the commodity will be increased, for example, if you are taking up the two products, you see, if you have considered the car, if the price of the car will be increased, automatically the price of the petrol will be increased here. So why? Because these are the complementary goods. One goods will be depend to the other goods here. So if the car price will be increased, ultimately the petrol price will be increased here. If the price will be going down, ultimately these prices are going down. So that is called as complementary goods. And if you go for the next one, unrelated goods. So unrelated goods means here there is no effect of the unrelated goods here. So whenever we consider the product A and product B, so here if the price of the product A either increase or decrease, there is no change in the demand of another commodity here, because it is not related to the product here. If the tea and coffee, we say that it is a alternate or substitute product. If you are taking up bricks and houses, it is called as complemented products here. But here, these are the unrelated products. At that time, the price of the unrelated product, it is not affected to the demand of another product. So these are called as cross elasticity demand, having of different categories based on the goods here. And we go for the last one, that is called as advertising elasticity of demand. Here, the advertising elasticity of demand means whenever we are changing the advertising cost of the product, cost of the advertisement will be increased or decreased. Ultimately, whatever the proportion of the demand will be increased or decreased, that we are discussing the advertising elasticity of demand. If the cost of the advertisement will be increased, ultimately it leads to the sales of the particular product. Here the cost will be decreased, the sales will be going down here. So how much the proportional changes are there between these two things, that we are discussing the advertising elasticity of demand here. So these are the types of elasticity of demand here. Thank you, everyone.